Hey guys, well, I'm doing things a little bit different today. Mr. Camera Guy isn't available, and I did not want to wait for him to get home to film this video. Just wanted to make a quick preserving your harvest video and bring you guys along as I make my breakfast this morning. What I've done is, if you watched my watermelon video last week when I harvested my watermelon, I got, I think, around 7 large watermelon. Now, I gave some away, but what I also tried was freezing it. And what I did was I just chopped it up in little cubes and freeze it on a cookie sheet. I've got a shot of the cookie sheet right here that I froze it all on. Isn't that beautiful? All those lovely watermelon chunks. So I've been freezing it and making smoothies. And I thought I would let you guys know it's a great way to use up that watermelon that you can't eat up fresh. It's a great way to freeze it and preserve it and stick it in your freezer so you can have it for smoothies. We've actually been making some wonderful strawberry margaritas out of it also. But just wanted to go over with you my really easy and healthy smoothie recipe. So what I've got here is my blender. I've already thrown the ingredients in just to make it quicker. But what I added was maybe a half a cup or just a large spoonful or so of just plain Greek yogurt. Greek yogurt is really, really good for you. It's fat-free, low in calories, excellent addition to your smoothie to get some protein. I put about, oh, I think I've got maybe a cup or so of milk in there, just regular 2% milk. And then I also added some of this wonderful flaxseed. It's ground flaxseed. It's called Bob's Red Mill, I believe is the, yeah, Bob's Red Mill is the brand. It's an excellent way to get your omega-3 fish oils in your body, and you really don't even notice it in your smoothie. I also added a handful of my wonderful fresh from my garden frozen watermelon and a handful of frozen blueberries. But you can put any fruit in, but because I have watermelon, I went ahead and added that. I've also made it with strawberries, and it's really, really good with strawberries as well. So I'm going to go ahead and blend this up and show you. Oh, it's so refreshing. So we'll go ahead and hit blend. It's going to get a little loud here for a second. Little bit thick, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and add a little bit more milk just to loosen it up. And I have a smoothie every single morning for breakfast. I make them for my family, they love them. It's a great way to start the day. It's also really quick to grab when you're going out the door to work and you want to take something with you. Let me show you how wonderful this looks. Now I'm filming this on my iPhone, so I know it's not the usual quality that you're used to from my videos, but like I said, I just cannot wait for him to get home. Okay, this is actually really, really thick. I would probably add maybe just a little bit more milk. Whoa! Here we go. Okay, it just dumped all into my glass. Let me show you this. Doesn't this look great? Oh, it's so good. That watermelon flavor just comes right through. It's delicious. So, watermelon smoothies for breakfast, a great way to use up those watermelons that you might have growing in your garden. Thanks a lot for watching, and let me know what you do with watermelon. If you have any special recipes that you like to use it in, how you use it up, let me know in the comments below. So, we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.